was.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back. Another episode of Attack on
Another
Show.
Another amazing episode of Attack on Show.
Can't get rid of us, although you keep clicking the link, so shame on you.
Yeah, get it.
I'm Robbie.
And I'm Jay Marsh.
And before we tell you all the exciting stuff coming up, we got some important news to share with you.
Incredibly important news.
What do they need to do?
What they need to do is click the like button.
Yes, and then the subscribe button.
Because the subscribe button's important. Yes. But what's the most important button?
That's your part.
It's the bell, people.
Yes.
Click the bell so you know when we're coming out with a new episode.
You need to know. You don't want to miss, because when you watch it, it's outdated news.
Yeah, it's old stuff. You don't want that at that point.
You're really going to beat yourself up.
But if you subscribe and then like the bell, we're going to be there for you.
Yeah, very important.
That's our job.
Yes, and then post all over all your social media how all your friends, they're missing out on all the fun. They need to subscribe to Attack on Show.
Oh my God, it's an incredibly good time. It's like, it's like sitting at the bar with your buddies, having drinks, talking about what's on the tube.
You can't do that now, so you might as well watch us and have a drink with us.
Amen. And look.
Boom, we got you covered.
No mask. I know. Sexy.
Yeah. We actually quarantined together. Me and Jeff have been living in this basement for the last 4 months.
Yeah. It's been wild.
Yeah. So that's why we're going without
masks. I've done things I never thought I would do before.
I don't want to remember.
Yeah, I know.
Anyway, we got some fun stuff lined up for you. We're going to kick a movie maniac minute because there's so much exciting stuff happening.
There's so much going on. I'm excited to watch you.
It's going to be really hard to get it all in a minute. But I'm going to do my best, everybody.
Yeah.
So stay tuned for that.
So when that happens, Rob's going to walk over to Studio C and take that care of it? Or
Studio B.
Oh, B tonight.
We only have two studios. We're not that fancy.
Oh, you didn't look. Did you go right on the other hallway?
No.
Oh, okay. Weird.
All right. And then we're going to do an Extreme It. This is a pseudo Extreme It.
This
is a movie that was in theaters. It's not a streaming
original. This is going to be a pleasant surprise for all of you. Absolutely.
Yeah, we're going to take a look at Peanut Butter Falcon, which is currently streaming on Hulu and Amazon Prime.
Yep.
You're going to stick around and see if that's a
what
movie
we have
worth
after
watching.
That?
After that, we're going to take a look at Binge-worthy. Yeah, that's your favorite.
It is.
We're going to take a look at Amazon Prime's Bosch. Okay.
So I'm going to say,
And then I Miss My MTV, my new favorite. I love dancing to this song.
Yes, he loves dancing,
Oh, my
period.
God, I love this song.
I made you the Rob dance.
This
tonight,
is, it's Bakar or Bakar? I don't know.
Bakar.
The way it's spelled. But the song is Hell and Back, and you're going to love this tune. I promise you, you won't be disappointed. Stick around to the end.
Is that tonight's show, Rob?
It's tonight's show, everybody. So make sure you stick around. As always, I'm Robbie.
And I'm Jay Marsh.
And this is
Attack on Show.
All right, we're back.
We are back.
You made it this far.
You did.
Why turn off now?
Well, hey, we still get credit for you at this point.
There's a lot of movie news coming out.
You know, there's a whole bunch of movie news coming out tonight. Rob's going to make sure we get that all covered. So he's going to head over to Studio B to get all that stuff covered.
There's a lot to cover.
You guys don't realize, like, it's a hell of a jaunt over to Studio B.
It is. It's very far. So I'm going to head over.
Yeah, absolutely.
We're going to get you guys filled in.
Yep, absolutely. And then you're going to come back, right?
Yeah, I'll come back.
Because that was weird that last time you didn't.
Yeah, it was really
weird. All right, so head over to Studio B.
All right. All right, Studio B, it's time for Movie Maniac Minute. So let's get things started with that clock. Entertainment Weekly released brand new pictures of The Mandalorian Season 2 today. You can get your first look at Baby Yoda, who looks like he has aged a little bit. Oh, but he's so cute still. The series is scheduled to be released on Disney Plus October 30th. Angry fans at Amazon's The Boys? That's right. The streaming service released the first three episodes of season two and are now holding out the remaining episodes to be released on a weekly format. That's right, fans are bombarding Amazon with negative reviews of The Boys, rating it down to a 2.5. The show's so great, we just don't want to wait for it. Why the change, Amazon? I understand with other streaming services with a month-to-month price tag, but Amazon Prime, you buy by the year. It makes no sense. Release them all now. With Mission Impossible 7 resuming filming, there's some behind-the-scenes footage released of Tom Cruise doing an amazing death-defying motorcycle stunt. Check out the footage here. Not gonna catch me doing that. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all the time that I've got. Make sure you stick around. There's plenty more coming on Attack on Show. I'm heading back to Studio A. It's too hot over here.
Hey, welcome back.
Thank
I always
you.
Get a little weirded out when he's gone and runs all the way over to Studio B, but you guys don't realize it's quite a jaunt.
It's way over
it
there.
It is, yeah. Hey, can we get a golf cart?
Maybe a Segway. We might be able to.
Yeah, they're super cheap at this point right now. Yeah, no. Sweet.
Maybe we get 1,000 subscribers.
You'll give me one?
We can hook up a Segway. Yes.
Oh, guys, please. Tell your friends. Help me out. I want a Segway.
On this week's segment of Extreme It.
Yes.
I think it's Extreme It. Be camera. We don't really know where to fit it in.
It's kind of a mix of the two.
Yeah. Yeah. This movie did go out to theaters prior to it coming out, but it is currently streaming on Hulu and Amazon Prime. So you got two chances to see this movie.
You do, yes. Whatever one you have or prefer.
Or both. Watch it on both. See if there's a difference.
Sure.
I don't know.
Oh,
honestly, I'd watch it more than once, so why not? We're going to take a look at Shia LaBeouf's Peanut Butter Falcon. Which, I gotta tell you, this movie, I will give you a quick synopsis of it before we start getting into our opinions on this. Basically, there's a character, Zach, who is autistic, and the backstory on him is that his parents had abandoned him. The state didn't really know what to do with him, so they placed him in like a retirement home because they figured that's the place where he could get his best care.
Yes, absolutely.
He's a huge wrestling fan.
Massive.
He watches this old VHS about
over
wrestling.
Over and over. And to me, that was a really sad part of all of this.
That was
a
VHS.
That was just he's watching the same thing over and over again and fell in love with watching that. Yes.
Yeah, and knowing it's a VHS and wondering what time frame.
Yeah, exactly.
But on this VHS tape, the big wrestler at the time is advertising his wrestling school, and Zach wants to go to the school.
Come to my wrestling school and become a badass.
That's what he wants to do with the rest of his life.
So he gets his roommate to help him escape. As he escapes, during that time, Shia LaBeouf's character, Tyler, is facing some hard times.
Yeah, really kind of running from his own demons at that point.
Yeah, he creates some problems of his own, and then he goes on the run, and together, they run into each other, both alone, out in the world.
Maybe we could be friends and buddies, bro dogs, and chill. Have a good time.
And together, they start this kind of cross-country foot race where he decides to help Zach get to this wrestling school.
Yeah, yeah. And, Rob makes a mention of the point that Shia LaBeouf is incredible.
I got to tell you, I've been a huge fan. I've been a big fan of Shia LaBeouf's acting for a long time. I've given this kid a lot of credit since the days of him being a kid to now. In a career where it looked like the sky, he was just capturing everything with Transformers. Indiana Jones, when you looked at those before they were, Transformers, the first one, is great. And then he has Indiana Jones.
And he's great in Transformers.
Yes.
People miss that.
Yes, he does a great job in that. And then he had Indiana Jones lineup, which obviously...
But he was also great in a poorly scripted movie.
Yes.
He is phenomenal.
Regardless of his personal decisions, I gotta say, you cannot knock the guy's craft and commitment to acting.
No. Rob and I often take the approach when it comes to some of these actors and films. I don't want to get too off the reservation here, but you kind of got to let their other stuff go and really make credit to what they are as actors and their craft.
Yes.
And he's one of those that, I don't give a what he does in his personal life, which really isn't that bad. I mean, he's just a little out there. But that is we've talked about, the torment of a great artist.
Yes.
And just in creating incredible art, and he's one of those
actors. No, growing
actors.
Up in front of the camera is not easy, and the fact that he's not in prison and still putting out great
movies.
It
says a whole lot, absolutely, yes.
The movie is produced by the same people who made Little Miss Sunshine, which is another old fave of mine.
Yes.
A great movie, and if you've seen Little Miss Sunshine, you'll see a lot of similarities as far as the art house style that this movie is done and the way it's filmed.
Mm-hmm.
This movie is a very heavy character-drawn film. So I say that because you're not going to get a lot of action. You're not going to get any special effects. You're going to get a character-driven movie.
No, but what you get out of this is incredible acting.
Amazing
heart
acting.
So if you're looking for a film
acting.
And a lot of heart and a lot of emotion, and this is, in many ways, when Rob suggested this to me, we kind of sit down. This was an incredible surprise. I was not prepared for this.
Yes.
And I really, and I'm getting into the actual thing, I was not prepared for this. And I don't think I would have approached it in any other way.
No, I did hear some about
you
the
will not
movie
be prepared.
Prior.
You
no.
will be prepared regardless.
I heard some about this from other people about being such a great film. I tried not to pay too much attention because I don't want the expectations set on something like this to go into it with a high expectation. But even with the high expectation of this movie, it far succeeded those expectations.
Yeah, it doesn't fail in any levels.
It is
none of this
so
does.
Good. And there's a great backstory between Shia LaBeouf and his brother.
Yes.
Played by Shane, who I always call him John Bernthal. But you'll always be Shane. Sorry, John. But there's a great backstory. And the way I have to say the film is edited, I thought was amazing. Because what they do is they kind of run a parallel between Zach and Shia LaBeouf's character to what Shia LaBeouf had with his brother. And some of the scenes when they cut back and forth, it's like heart gut-wrenching where you're like, I'm not crying, you're crying.
Crying. Oh, no, I was crying in this. And I will say this. This is... a beautifully emotional movie.
Yes, it's a great film. Dakota Johnson does a great job supporting character.
Yes.
Where, you know, she's the person who's in charge of taking care of Zach. She has to try and find out where he's at because he's on the run. I loved the dynamic, the chemistry between her and Shia LaBeouf. I just thought the way it came off, they didn't overplay it. It was written so well that, like, Shia LaBeouf is kind of this gruff person, but yet the things he says are just so in tune and things, perfectly said
exactly,
that it catches her interest, and it is so well written.
And let me ask you, what do you want for him?
I'm not going to sell him to you.
No, no, what do you want for his life, his future?
This is one of those, ladies and gentlemen, where I'm really kind of amazed why not everybody and their brother is kind of talking about this film.
They will after they watch this episode.
They will, hopefully, yes, absolutely.
We want to give a couple shout-outs.
We do, some really cool shout-outs.
Yes.
Yale Wolf is in this, who writes under Eminem's label at Detroit Classic.
We featured him on I Miss My MTV.
We did, absolutely. And then Jake Roberts, or Jake the Snake Roberts, who has always been a fan favorite of mine when it comes to wrestling and WWE.
A little age.
He absolutely is.
I had a hard time I knew him, but I didn't know if it was really him.
Well, yes, no. And it's, you know, we run across it sometimes, but it is a pleasure to be someone who's dead. Yeah. Again, this movie is all about kind of people dealing with their own demons and kind of coming through all of that. And if you know Jake Roberts' story, and if you get a chance to look it up, he's another one of those people. Yeah. He's kind of gone through his bad times and come out of it.
Yeah, and Thomas Hayden Church, who plays main wrestler.
Yes.
What is it? It's Clint. He plays the main wrestler who Zach wants to meet. He has a small part in this, but such a pivotal and amazing. He's always good. But
he's always good. I mean, this is one of those guys that you're like, why is he not big? Well, you know, he's kind of those guys that you don't know why he didn't end up bigger.
Huge shout out to the casting director in this, because these were every single character in this was perfectly cast.
That and the editor. I mean, the editing and
directing, cinematography was great. The boating scenes. This movie all around is great. So please, I'm going to vote watch it.
Absolutely, watch it. Yes.
And make sure you leave us some comments below after you watch this. Let us know if you think we're wrong or if you found your new favorite film.
Because I'm kind of there.
I think you guys will. I'm not going to regret saying that. I think that's going to be the outcome. And hate us now, thank us later. What was the old saying?
It doesn't really matter. Just watch it.
Is that the old saying?
Yeah.
All right. You want to move on to Binge Worthy?
Binge Worthy!
Listen up now. This is serious.
I was just wondering,
No! Binge Worthy! I love that. You know I do, though. Whatever.
Yeah, it's awesome.
So what are we covering now?
On this week's segment of Binge Worthy, we're taking a look at Amazon Prime's original show, one of their first.
You know, it's funny because we kind of referenced this, Rob and I did back and forth, that I really think this is kind of their first.
Yeah.
That they really pushed, they really focus as their first exclusive that they produced and put money towards.
Yeah, we're taking a look at Bosch, which, Jeff, I don't know if you want to give the overview about this. It's a homicide detective story.
It's a homicide detective story, and it's very, very LA Noir. If you're not familiar with that, this is one of those, like, I'm always an advocate to get through the pilot. I will say the pilot pulled me in on this. It had a very LA Noir type feel about it. It was dark. He played that character. Again, we're talking at modern times on this, but there was very much that feel. He is a former Special Forces officer that is a detective in the homicide unit of the LAPD. And he's an incredibly complex character. Titus Wilver?
Yeah, that's who you're referencing by he.
About he, and he pays Harry Bosch. And this is all based off novels.
Yes.
Which it spiked my interest in the fact that I'm now looking into those. This guy, when we talk about casting, I didn't know who he was until this. Oh. But oh my God, did they do an incredible job.
I knew him from The Town. Partner in The Town.
Yeah.
Which that kind of sparked my interest to see this movie because I really liked him in The Town.
Yes.
So I was interested to see him carry a TV series. The series did come out in 2014. There are six seasons of it.
Yes.
And I believe they're about 12 episodes a season. They're not the full 24.
No.
It's the full they're now
episode.
They're
very kind of a streaming now
episode.
Yes.
That's the new normal.
Yeah, that's the new season.
Episodes.
12.
His partner is Jamie Hector. And yes, it's basically Bosch. It starts where he's like facing trial for a possible wrongful shoot.
Sure.
So it gets you kind of questioning whether or not the legitimacy of this detective, is he clean or is he not, which is, you know, the twist right from the get-go. So then you start kind of watching on the show. Jeff is a lot bigger fan of this. I will go the opposite to where, honestly, I thought Titus, I feel like he's terrible in this.
Really?
This show.
Oh, that's interesting.
I really liked him in The Town, but when watching him, the man's facial expressions, and I don't know if it's editing, pacing, or what, but like whenever anybody is talking to him, he's constantly just making weird faces and staring.
Wow, that's interesting.
And it just it ate away at me so much. Bro. I'm like, can you just look at them and talk to them?
No, I will tell.
No one walks anymore with the jacket over their shoulder and coming into work.
Wow, you're really taking. And I felt like
it was so cheesy.
No, it is funny because I kind of the LA noir aspect of this, and I kind of get that. I can see where Rob's coming from on that, but I kind of respected that. You're really building a character in this individual of not being your average detective. And, you know, some of the things that go on with him, it's funny. I really fell in love with him as a character. He is a driving force. You know, there's some other great people involved in that. Lance Reddick, who plays his chief, who is the chief in, like, every cop movie ever.
He does a great job.
He plays that
role. To me, he was really tough in this. I love him in John Wick. I can't stand him
really?
In this role.
God, wow! And I've actually loved him in this role. You know, it's seldom that we sit and do this.
Yeah.
But you know, we tend to agree on this. But to be so different in this.
He's amazing in John Wick. I like him in those roles. But he's too stiff.
Bosch, Deputy Chief, been subpoenaed too.
It was very distracting for me
to
watch.
Can we both
him.
Agree that it's well written? That there is a lot of like backstory and the things that interplay in this.
There's a lot of far-fetched story. I don't know.
I get that, but I guess I kind of suppress some of that in this, everybody, that the fact that this is, it's just a fun story. I kind of throw some of this out. Yeah, it's funny because some of the, you know, there's some tactical aspects of gun handling and stuff like that can take me out of a movie.
The escape was awful.
Yes, I mean, there's some parts of this where I'm like, okay.
I got to say, I think to me, the highlights of the series was Troy Evans, who seems to never age, who's always looked the same since back in Frighteners.
But he plays a detective in everything. He's fantastic.
But I thought he was great in this, and Gregory Summit Cummings.
I knew both of those he was going to. We've been doing this too long, folks. I knew exactly what he was going to say.
They play partners, and their attitudes and the wit that they put with those two characters, I find really amusing. I would love a spinoff just of those two, because their attitudes are honestly as realistic
that
as
would
you
be
could
great
get.
Like, yes, there really is true. Yes.
Did you have sex with him?
Jesus, no. Why would you think that?
Why would we think that?
I don't know.
I thought they have a great partnership, but again, the series was not enough to hold me. I did make it through season one because I was curious about the story.
Oh, wow, interesting.
After that, I had to drop it. So I am going to say I would pass given what's out there.
You know, and I'm actually gonna contest that, the fact that I think it's fantastic. I think it's a really fun kind of show that you don't have to give too much into, but at the same time incredibly entertaining. I'm gonna say absolutely watch it.
The last time we disagreed, the score was 2-1 me, that I was right, but no one's keeping charge or keeping track of that. So
wait, you literally tattooed it. Yeah, it's weird. All right,
2-0.
Whatever. Yeah, no,
anyway,
sorry.
Leave comments below. Let us know if
you
agree with
me or Jeff.
Yeah, we
would love your input on the show. Absolutely.
I'd be real curious to see what you think. Either we helped you watch a new or find a new show, or we saved you a bunch of time.
Absolutely,
That's what we're here for. We're here for you.
We're here for yes, contributing.
And we're also here to listen to some music.
Yeah, are you ready for this?
I'm so ready.
I know he is. Listen, he's so pumped for this, people. This is absolutely fantastic.
I miss my MTV.
Oh, are you excited for this?
I'm very excited.
Oh, me
for
too,
this.
Bro. Absolutely.
Very
yes.
excited. I'm excited to bring you guys this video. I love this song. It's the British singer, songwriter, and model. I feel
it's
like we're
handsome.
Brothers.
No.
I mean, all the same talent.
Yeah, no, absolutely, Rob. Yeah. Completely. All talent.
The song is Hell and Back, and I gotta tell you, the moment this song hit, I can't stop moving to it.
No, absolutely.
So,
yes.
I gotta cut away because I can't wait any longer. Everybody, you're gonna enjoy this track, and I can't wait to share it with you. This is Hell and Back.
Enjoy.
I missed a lot of love with a lot of drugs, then I found you. She liked petty crime, she had green eyes like Mountain Dew. And where she go, I'll never know, her friends bounce to. I guess it's their loss, but they'll never know what we'll amount to. And would you be my light, be my yellow? PYT walking down Portobello, put a smile on his face. At the end of the day, MDMA helped us fly away. Who'd have known you would save my life? Who'd have known you would fly my kite? Could you tell, could you tell? Could you tell? Could you tell where my head was at when you found me? Me and you went to hell and back just to find peace. Man, I thought I had everything, I was lonely. Now you're my everything, I was lonely. Yeah.
You like
like it? Yeah, I do. It's funny, and I will. Very few of you are watching at this point. That's okay. We get it. I will say, I was at the gym.
They stuck around because I told them to.
Well, absolutely. And I was at the gym the other day, and I have to laugh because, you know, Rob throws a lot of music at me, which is phenomenal. We kind of throw things and bounce things back and forth. And I'm like, have my headphones on, but they weren't on at the point. And I heard the song come on. I'm like, and I'm tapping my earbuds. I can't figure out. And I look up, and it's actually playing. So again, always ahead of the curve.
Yes.
Always ahead of the curve. Even if it's by a couple weeks, always there. Attack on Show.
No, this is a great song.
It grows on you. This is definitely one that grows on you. The more you listen to it, you're like, I need to hear
you
that.
You love it, and then you really love
it. Yes, absolutely. Yes.
But Bakar, he's a great artist. He's got like an indie rock. Like,
yeah, he's
going
to be there for a while.
Yeah.
I hate to. This one will be there for a while.
Yeah, very new. I mean, he just debuted in like 2018 with a mixtape, and now he's got this track, which is just blowing up on YouTube. And now
did
that Attack on Show.
Did you ever listen to a mixtape I gave you?
Yeah.
Mine?
Yeah.
Okay.
I was a little weirded out.
All right.
That was why I got the restraining order.
Did you? No? Okay. All right. Yeah.
Everybody, thank you for sticking around this long. I know it's very tough, and we really appreciate
we
it.
We do.
If you're still here, might as well click the subscribe button.
Tell your friends too, because if you're here more than like, you've already done that.
Yeah, you're part of the 1%. Thank you. As always, I'm Robbie.
And I'm G-Marsh.
And this is
Attack on Show.